Kim Jong-un and Disney are probably the unlikeliest of pairings, but one North Korean defector is marrying the two in his subversive art. I'm Frankie Greek for UpRocks, and Sunmu fled North Korea more than 20 years ago. He's been using his art for change ever since. Images of North Korean communism colliding with Western capitalism and pop culture. Sunmu, who uses a pseudonym which roughly translates to no boundaries, was a trained propaganda artist in North Korea, creating posters and murals championing the North Korean regime. After famine struck his country in the mid-90s, Mu defected to Seoul, South Korea, where he went to school, developing his art and his satirical political style. Mu juxtaposes capitalist and pop culture images with traditional propaganda, his old reality colliding with his current one. There are paintings of Kim Jong-il smiling, the bleak reality of North Korea reflected in his sunglasses, Kim Jong-un dancing among Disney princesses, and Kim Jong-il decked out in Nike and Adidas gear. But his satire hasn't always been understood. His first solo show in Beijing in 2014 was shut down by Chinese authorities, with more than 70 paintings seized and burned. The paintings satirized the type of propaganda Mu was once tasked with making, with slogans like, "North Korea is a good place to live." Names of North Korean leaders were painted on the floor, forcing guests to walk over them when they'd enter the exhibition. One painting that he was questioned for depicted a North Korean girl and a South Korean boy skipping hand in hand. But Mu says his art is less about provocation and more about promoting peace. On a painting of his called Hope, he writes, "I hope South and North Korea will live happily together." But as North Korea continues to conduct nuclear tests at an alarming rate, and South Korea responds with simulated defensive attacks of their own, that idea is increasingly as unlikely as the content of Mu's art. For UpRocks, I'm Frankie Greek.